I'm Jared Haynes, and this is a Rogue Outdoors hunt. This is an early September elk hunt in which Washington's really put the heat on us, and we can only hunt true spike bulls. So last night we sat up at a glassing point, and we looked to see what we could find, and we found a few, but that definitely limits the amount of elk that we're chasing after. So we picked out our spot we're going to go to this morning, and we'll see what we can find as the day goes on. Getting about a 5:30 in the morning start, and won't be bright until about 6:30. So we'll get up there, sit in the spot that we chose from last night, and then hopefully something comes into us. Alright, so we made it up to the top of the hill that we're going to, and we're just about to come out to an opening where the elk cross a lot, so we're gonna have to stop up here these bushes and kind of glass, see what we can see. So we're just following this elk path right up into where they go. They travel this up under this bank right here quite a bit. And so we're just gonna come sit down here and hope where we spotted them yesterday was down there. And so we're hoping that they get pushed back up here. Skyler's out here, he already got his buck this year. Got that out of a ground blind, so he's got that taken care of. Now he's on animal number two. Well, we're going up to the glassing spot to look for some elk, and here they are right here. There's a couple right here, one right there. It's another cow, it looks like.
Look at them all.
So
there's a bull.
Oh, look at them.
There's a bull in there.
We've got quite the
spikes out in front
group here. Where's the bull?
I want to say he's behind a tree.
That guy right there is the spike.
So the bull is fifth elk back.
There's the, okay, yeah, there's the bull.
Sixth elk back, I'm sorry.
And there's the spike. The spike is that very front guy looking.
We've made it up to the top of this ridge, and this is an area that I've never been up to. And we just heard some bugling. It's right up in this draw. So Jacob's gonna let out a bugle and see if we can hear something. There's a whole nother area that, you know, the way I haven't seen yet. We usually, as far as we've been, is up in these bushes here. We came from way down over there. So we've been putting in quite a few miles this morning. And if we can get a response, we're gonna head up here and see if we can look down into this draw and catch something, because bull is all we can look for.
Well, we are at our lunchtime. I heard some bugling, although I think that that ended up being some other hunters, which is kind of one of the risks you run, I guess you'd say, when you go after a bugle. I guess sometimes people are pretty convincing sounding. But I was able to spot them walking across the hillside, and then I could see them bugling. So we're now going to head back up towards camp and come over the top and then see what we run into this evening. There's not a lot of water up here, so we're kind of playing it off of where the water is at. All right, so we got a bull straight across from us. I was just doing some cow calling, and this guy comes popping out. He's a little bit frothy, that one.
We just got a first spot on a big bull. He came right across from us. He was right up in there. He came walking out and Skylar spotted him and he came across. I was using my little Primos cow call and I guess that got him to come out. And then he stood there broadside and I used the other camera and I got some good video of him. So I'll probably have shown that in the video right before this or something, but that's pretty cool. So he's not something we can shoot. It's true spike only in this area, but it's always good to see a bull. We're just walking along and I spotted this blue spray paint right here, which is actually a little toilet shed. And then I come over here to investigate. There's this little abandoned, like, cabin thing, which is kind of cool. You look inside here, like a old bed in there, and oil and stuff. Nobody's been in here in quite a while, but that's kind of cool. It's day two, so this would be Sunday. And we're sitting up at the glassing point. Last night, Jacob and I decided to come over here and sit at the glassing point, which overlooks all of this area that we've been hunting. Well, we started down here yesterday, went all the way up and around over there, back to that farthest hill. That's where we saw the bull. And then while we were eating some food, we went along back over in those trees, came up and we sat right up in there. Then we came all the way back, dropped in through this stuff, over to there, and then back to camp. Well, then in the evening, while Jacob and I were sitting up here, I spotted some elk, the whole herd that was over there. And Skylar had gone down and around and he was up over there. So we called him on the radio and told him to head over that way. The elk went here, started to come down here, and somebody, I would imagine, spooked them. They ran back up there. Then they ran out, and they ran through these trees. They were on their way to him, and he was out by that farthest power line. And then they caught his wind, turned around, and went back into the trees. Skylar followed him, and then somewhere right in there, took a shot at one of the spikes and at 40 yards, and it was just a little bit thick, and he wasn't able to get him. So today, he's back out there again. He should be somewhere out in that area. Jacob and I are looking for the herd, and then we'll go try and track him down. While we're at it, though, we decided to do a little bit of looking around, and there's quite a few deer down here, so I'm going to show that on the other camera. There's one guy right down there, another doe. If you come over, there's a few more right in there. Got moving along. I think I've got a total of 5 deer that I'd spotted so far. So, no bucks at the moment, and that spot is legal for bucks. 3-point and bigger, so if we get a chance, we'll try and go up there and get one.
Yeah, he's got 3 on the right side.
It's that lead one out of the two. It's getting ready. Wait for him to step. There's 2 deer right there. The one that's lower is the one that Jacob's going to go for. It's a 2x3. There's a spike right there, though. We got to get the spike out of the way. Shoot him.
Just on top.
So sometimes elk hunting doesn't always go in your favor, and right now would be one of those times. The elk are down here in this drainage, which is in a unit that we can't hunt. And so there's a lot of water down here, and it's been super dry. So there's not a lot of places for the elk to get water. So they're doing what they can, but that also means that they're not in a spot that we can shoot them. I'm going to try and put some binoculars on them and find out where the big bulls are in the herd, and then I'll try and get some good video of it. So, just putting some binos on, that's the biggest one out of the herd right there. That's who's running this group. Now, what we can hunt are the spikes, and it's hard to tell, but there's one right there. There was one that was somewhere down in here, and they're all kind of moving along, so it's hard for me to tell, but I think that's one. But I found three so far that are legal, and then there's one in the back, back here, but it has a little fork. And in Washington, for true spike, it has to be just two straight main beams with no branches. So out of this herd, we're down to three different elk that we can hunt. But that's the group right there. Well, we spotted the elk down low, and I got the footage with my camera. Now they're heading towards the unit where we can hunt. So we're hooking it back to the truck. We're gonna run down there and try and head them off as they're coming across into the unit we can hunt. So hopefully it works out. Well, this is day three, and we're up here at the glassing spot again. All the elk are still right down here below. Which is in an area that we can't hunt them. They have to go over and cross over into this timber stretch. So there's a bull that's coming in right now down low. He's coming in to challenge the bigger bull. He's kind of raking some trees, and they're screaming back and forth at each other. So we'll watch that for just a little bit, and then I think we're going to head up that way and go to a different unit and see if we can find some elk that are out in a spot, and we'll come back and check these guys later this evening. So we're up top, and it's really windy, but we're gonna try and walk in on them. This is an area that I've only scouted once before a couple years ago, but if you look, there's tons of sign that they're up here. So we're gonna try and sneak up and see if we just walk into something and give it our best shot. We're getting a lot of whiffs of elk smell. And so we're just going to do our best to see if we can walk into them. The wind is in our favor. It's blowing straight into our faces, and that's the way that the elk smell is coming. So hopefully we can just walk into them, and they won't even know we're coming. Well, we've got a mama and a couple babies that are just sitting here. The closest little baby is a spike. Yeah, you see if I can show you his head. Got little spikes. And mom. Tuesday, and we got one more day to hunt after this. The elk have finally made it out from down in that field. And let's see here. They finally made it out from that field. And so I'm going up top because that's where I saw them from the glassing point. Jacob and Skylar are down below. I'm going to go up here by where that cabin was, and that's where the elk herd that I saw this morning were. Hopefully no other hunters have gone up there already, so we'll see. So far, we've had a lot of misfortune, I guess you could say, for hunting. The elk have been staying down in a unit where we can't hunt them. And so we've been kind of hunting the stragglers that are out. We've seen a few bulls, some cows. This morning, I'm way up top here because I'm chasing a group of about 20 elk that I saw. But it's been pretty slow. This year the game regulations got changed, and so you're only hunting just a few elk because it's true spike only. And that means that the herds, when they normally are hunting, you can hunt cows, they break up more and they kind of get spread around, and so you're constantly running into little groups of elk. This year they've stayed all together because nobody's really been getting any elk. Out of the big herd that we've been watching, there's only 3 legal elk that you can hunt. So, and nobody's taken one. Skyler got a shot the second day at one of them. But that's as good as it's got. So, we'll see. This herd that was up here today, they came from somewhere up in here. They're a different addition to the unit in here. So, we'll see if I can run into them. Skyler and Jacob are coming back up from chasing that deer. They weren't able to get that. So we'll see. I think they might come up here and join me later this evening. I'm gonna make a big loop, go up here and around and see what we run into. It's just new country and I've never been up this end. So we'll go up here and see what we find. So Skyler and I are out here way back in now. And I just looked across this clearing, and there's this bull standing over there. He's the biggest bull I've seen. He's even bigger than Brutus. Wait for him to turn his head. Sorry for the shaking, this is offhand. And then over here, we've got some more. All right, so we've got today and tomorrow left. I'll have just shown the video of the bull that we saw. Skyler and I are gonna have to figure out how to get over there. We're gonna sit in kind of glass, see if we can find a spike out of them. But there's gotta be quite a few elk with a bull that big. And it's right over there. That's the bull, and all the others are right over there. So there's a road, but we got to get up above them and come down on them. So we'll see. We may end up having to go the long way, all the way over here and around. But if we can see a nice spike, it'll be worth it. Skylar. No. Skylar and I just made it over to the other side. This is literally right where they were bedded. The bowl was right here off my shoulder. And you'll see the video. I've got a little bit of video. There was a cow and that big bowl laying right in front of us. There's no spikes, though. However, the other video I've got of the elk walking right across that ridge.
We were just at.
Yeah, is right where we were just at. And there is a legal spike in that.
It's just walked out.
So we're going to grab our packs, head down here, and see. Maybe we can get them up in that top game field. Who knows? So we're running out of daylight, but I think we still got a few hours. So yeah, we're going to try and make a quick run at it. Bit of a... the train we're walking, I don't think it really does justice on how steep this is, but go down here and then all the way back up and then down another ravine and all the way back up, and then we'll be above camp and then we'll go out and see if we can get those deer. But one of the cool things is the elk leave these good trails, so we're able to follow the trails down. And it kind of shows us a place to cross all of this, because a lot of places there's rock faces that we're not able to get over, and this helps us navigate a little bit better. So well, last update for the day, maybe we came back into the woods back above where I started this morning and found a really, really big bull and a cow. There's more elk up in here, but I don't know where that herd that we saw earlier come up. They might have dropped down into the lower stuff. We're going to sit up here for about another 10 minutes and then we're going to head down back towards camp, and we'll be going right through some thick stuff that elk like to hang out in. So maybe we'll catch them down there. They might have headed over that way. But today was pretty eventful. Tons of elk. Only saw one legal spike out of all the groups, but that means there's another herd with another spike, so that's good. Tomorrow, which will be our last day here, we're going to come up here and spend all day up here. We'll go to the glassing spot in the morning, see if we can find some, and then come straight up and hike around back up in here. Looks like a lot of the elk are back up in this stuff, and then we're going to spend the last part of the evening just right up here in the woods. So hopefully we get something. If not, then, you know, most of the experience is just being here for the experience, and we'll be back again for late season. Started chirping back a bunch, but since then they haven't really made any noises. They're just bedded down up there. So Jacob and I are gonna sit down here and just wait for them. We're on a pretty main path, so hopefully they come down to us. Elk are right up here. those elk that were right up there. Just had a true spike come all the way down. Just right in that little opening, right past that little tree, which is about 40 yards, 45 yards. Just too far to shoot. So, ended up not being able to take a shot at him. Jacob bugled a bunch and got him to come down. He was just standing right up here in front of us. But there's nothing you can do with a traditional bow. And that's the only one out of that whole herd that you can even hunt.
Well, it was worth a good try. Didn't end up getting one. Had the bull come in right there at the very end. And that's the only true spike we've had a chance at. The three that were in the other herd down here below us never came out of the reserve. There wasn't one in the group that Skylar and I chased yesterday. This was the one that was coming across the hill that I got some video of with that other herd. But he got away. He didn't come in close enough. He's probably about 30-something, 38, 40 yards away. And with the recurve, just not going to take that shot. So we'll be back again for late season, see if we can pick one out. But yeah, the rule change in this unit, making it a true spike only unit, really limits the numbers of elk that you could get. But it's part of the enjoyment, just being out here and the hunting experience and trying to get one. So sometimes you get one, sometimes you don't. Anyways, thanks for watching.
All right, so we're almost to the dirt road to head up and go elk hunting. And this guy's just standing here on the side of the road. He has a big body and a nice girl. I think we're gonna name him Charles.
Charles, huh?
Yeah. Call it Charles, see if he'll look up here.
Charles! He doesn't like Charles.
He looked up. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
I want to get just another minute or so of video. They do funny stuff sometimes. I got video last year of one of them, and there were two of them actually. And the one in the back came up and started smacking the other one in the butt with its paw. It's kind of funny.